Throughout history, people have looked for God in many different places, but our first guest found the Lord in some place you won't believe. In her hair.
In her hair.
In her hair.
Okay, we're here to talk about her new book, I Found God in My Hair, 98 Spiritual Principles I Learned from My Hair, is actress, author, and filmmaker, Tanya Wright. Welcome to Arise.
Yes,
Tanya,
thank
welcome.
You.
So is this just a catchy title, or did you really find the Lord in your hair?
I really did find God in my hair.
Is he in there right now? Let me see.
That's what someone said.
Okay.
When I read the title,
they said in there.
I read the title and was like, does it mean that God was tumbling
out?
Where
All
is
right.
it?
Well, hallelujah.
Yeah, hallelujah.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
So
it smells good.
Yeah, thank
yeah,
you.
It smells really good.
It's based on the spiritual principles I learned as a result of my relationship with my hair and things that I was learning, like patience, like resilience, like shedding is a natural part of letting go. And so about in 2010, I cut off all my hairs. My life was sort of crazy and I was sort of rebuilding it.
Was there a breakup?
No, there wasn't a breakup. Actually, my brother died.
Oh.
Like I said, my life had sort of dispersed and I was rebuilding it. And sometimes I think when you're rebuilding something, you come to the realization that it's not going to be the same that it was before. So I cut off all my hair. And I said, I'm going to actually wear it the way it grows out of my head. Fancy that. Revolutionary concept, right? And this new relationship with my hair, I was learning to have more patience. I was learning that shedding is a natural part of life. I was learning resilience.
How did you wear your hair before? Did you have a relaxer? Was it in a different style?
I have fried, dyed, you know, laid to the side. I've done everything that anyone has ever done to their hair.
Okay.
You know, you can imagine. And also as an actor, you know, I wore a lot of weaves for different roles. I just decided I was going to wear my hair naturally.
So why did you decide to share your journey and these principles with the world?
Because I thought that they could be helpful to people. You know, I found God in my hair are literally the things that I learned from this new relationship with my hair, and I thought that they could be helpful to other people.
What was your relationship with your hair like before? I mean, some women have a very adversarial relationship with their hair. In fact, they hate their hair.
Right.
And they talk about it in a very derogatory way.
Yeah, it was always that thing, you know. I wouldn't say that I had a bad relationship with my hair. I would say I had a distant relationship with my hair. It was an intimate relationship with my hair. I am the only one in my family with hair that looks like this. And so my mother, she was like, you go, girl. You figure that out on your own. You know what I mean?
Good luck.
Good luck.
Right, right.
For most of your life. For most of my life. And I was like, ooh, wow, I got to figure this out. And so for whatever reason, in 2010, I was determined to figure it out. And then I went to the other side of this rabbit hole and wrote this book, and I'm developing a hair care line, and we're doing a web series. So, you know, now hair is my world.
So have you enjoyed being natural? Is it a lot less fuss to deal with?
I feel freer than probably I've ever been in my life.
Really?
Happier, more playful. It's just, it's me.
Do you think it's impacted your career or any roles that you've gone up for?
Yeah, people ask me that a lot. The short answer is absolutely, it is actually, I think, improved my career.
Oh, why do you say
to
that?
To be frank with you.
Because you feel more confident and comfortable in your skin?
Yeah, there was something actually that happened a number of years ago when I was on a show called 24. You guys watched season one on 24. If you remember, my character's name was Patty Brooks. I had on a wig, and it was kind of like flippy, and it was like very wiggy.
It was kind of Condoleezza-ish.
Exactly. Yes. And I came in one day and I said to the hair person, I kind of want to wear my real hair. Now, that's a problem on a show like that because it's continuity, right? Everything has to be exactly the same. And then we had a conversation with the executive producer. He looked at me and looked at my hair. He said, wear your own hair. And then he asked me a very simple question, and that was, why didn't you always wear it that way? And I was like,
was he white?
Question. He was.
Okay.
Complicated answer. And he's like, you know, wear your hair. And it was actually very liberating.
So now do you get a lot? Let me touch it. What does it feel like?
Yeah, I do.
And are you offended when people do that?
I'm actually not. You know.
Yeah.
I'm actually not.
All right, let's talk about Orange is the New Black.
Yes.
Wow. Hot show on Netflix. Hot show on Netflix. What's it been like to be a part of that amazing cast and to work with Laverne Cox?
Yeah, I've got to say, you know, first, I'll preface this by saying I have been lucky and fortunate and so very grateful to be on some of the most critically acclaimed shows in the history of the medium. From ER to 24 to NYPD Blue, True Blood for 7 seasons.
And The Cosby Show.
And The Cosby Show. We can't forget The Cosby Show.
The Cosby Show.
I know, you're right. But Orange is different. And I can't really explain or identify why that is. The role that I play, Crystal Brissett, you know, the wife of a transgender character, it's extraordinary, and the cast is extraordinary. Everything about this show is extraordinary and big. Mm-hmm. You know, when we shot it a couple years ago, I remember getting the call from my agent and looking at this great material, and my thought was, God, I hope someone finds it. You know, because it's Netflix, it's on the web. I don't know what that means. I don't know what that looks like. I didn't have a picture of it in my mind.
Oh, we found it.
Oh.
Yeah, we found it all right.
And I'm so grateful you did.
Yeah. Yeah. Will we find you next season?
Sorry?
Will we find you in the third season?
Yes, we are literally in the midst of shooting season 3.
Oh.
That's so exciting.
And speaking of finding, where can we find your hair care products?
Yes.
Okay.
Everything is on harriets.com, H-A-I-R, like hair.
Oh, okay. Very clever.
Harriets.com.
I love that.
And today, as of today, we're also doing this workshop, or I Found God in My Hair workshop, where you can actually download the workshop, and we will send you copies of the books. I've been going around the country doing a lot of natural hair events.
And these principles all help people deal with the type of hair that they have.
Yes.
Okay, right. So if you're looking for God, he or she could be in your hair. So go check out the book and the website.
Yes.
Thank you so much
Thank
for joining
guys.
Us.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Is he in
I'm
there?
Like looking for him right now.
Lord, come on out. Yeah.
We'll be right back with more Rise Entertainment 360. We're going to look for God.
Need you,